Hey guys, welcome back to another Peaceful Challenge episode. Today we got huge plans once again. We want to build a large tree farm, a furnace array, and a melon farm that would supply the tree farm with bone meal. So basically it could run infinitely. We need this mostly for charcoal. So here in our concrete factory, we also have a furnace array. It's actually currently running. That can turn sand into glass blocks. In order to get fuel, we thought about using charcoal, and today we want to build the tree farm for that. So, the plan is actually to build a dark oak tree farm that would produce about 21,000 logs per hour, which we can turn with another furnace array directly into charcoal. So smelt the logs into charcoal, use the charcoal to fuel that furnace array, basically, and the rest will be stored. We can then manually bring it over and fill up the chests down there with it. We already spent a lot of time designing the farm and also on the decoration. It's mostly done by Glotz, Panda, and Mals. And we decided to not build the farm here at the main end island because it's actually so huge, it wouldn't fit there nicely. The obsidian pillars would be in the way, so we decided to go to the outer end islands. The problem is that, we thought obviously about directly hooking up the charcoal to the furnace array here, but it's not really necessary since we have shulker boxes now. We can just fill up enough shulker boxes, bring over 100,000 charcoal at once, which lasts for smelting 800,000 glass. So we don't need to do this often. We don't need to directly hook it up. All right, so we went out and we're searching for a suitable location.
But do we want to go super far out?
No.
That's what I'm kind of thinking. I mean, if we just set up beside the end city, someone can tear it down later.
Yeah. Do we want to do that?
I don't know. Well, I have no problem with that.
Keep in mind, we can't rotate. We need to build this in the same orientation. See.
Well, yeah. If it goes lengthwise, there's probably enough space. But if it doesn't, then...
We can rotate it one way, because the height limiting works in the south and east. But, yeah.
Okay.
Basically, good rule of thumb, don't rotate it.
Yeah, it would actually fit here. If you remove density, it would be perfect.
Oh, well, then I think it's probably a good idea, because then it's not too far.
Yeah,
removing the city would take no time at all.
Yeah. I mean, Glossline doesn't just sit down and do it.
Yeah, I guess we
it's a perfect place.
Give me a second, I'm still removing the platform underneath.
So after the end city was removed, we had to gather a very large amount of materials to be able to build this. So we needed about 12,000 glass, which we could luckily now make with the sand tuber and the furnace array. So we got a little bit of charcoal, just had the tree farm running for a bit, the old one. Then the new concrete and wool farms come in super handy now for builds. All the colored blocks, we got them covered, except a bit of terracotta here and there. Then we had to buy polished diorite again from the stonemason, some quartz. Luckily, we already had a lot of dirt from digging out building sites, so we got the melon farm covered with that. So all in all, it took us quite some time to get all the materials. Miles had to go out squid hunting again for over an hour to get all the ink sacs. We should really build a farm for it soon, but there's a lot of things we actually need to do. everything summed up, we probably spent an entire recording session gathering the materials, but there wasn't all the prep work that was required. So the outer end islands are also not completely flat, so we had to either fill up a large amount to not make it look odd or mine away a lot of endstone. We decided to mine the endstone.
Oh, Mango, if you want, you can set up the filters already, I think.
Mm-hmm.
That's something you can do.
Yep. Do we have an anvil?
I already brought the filter items.
Ooh, okay.
Well, since we had a few stacks of A nuggets, I thought we could use them. I think they are in one of those two shocker boxes. Yeah, the left one.
Yeah. Wasn't there like another system for Drupal where we took an output from? We also had some saplings in there.
There we have a buffer for saplings.
Do we also need to put some in there?
That doesn't need. No, we don't need to fill them, but since I brought some more sticks, we can put some into there. Just to make sure that the first rounds are somewhat saved.
How do I get down there now at this point?
Good question. Maybe dug in from the side.
Yeah.
Dig in from the side. I think that's the way to go now. Wait, how do I get in? I think we're also still missing a sign.
Oh yeah, there's a sign missing by those chests or
playing on off.
Yeah.
Oh, or is that the switch for charcoal or wood collection mode?
Ooh. I feel like that might be the charcoal switch, but I don't know.
The first three were the sapling filters, right?
Yes, I think so.
Okay.
You can just look if they go towards the dropper that dispenses them to the player, then those are the ones.
You would also need a second filter item. It's different.
I guess you can... Well, you don't have to name those. It just
I am boss. I'm good, right?
Yeah. Or endstone. We have a lot of that as well.
Do we have some dark oak logs as well for the filters?
Ooh.
I don't know if there's any left.
No.
Did we use double speed or normal for those?
Double, so we need at least 4 stacks.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe we need to grow a tree. Don't we have bone meal and saplings?
Oh, yeah. We can get bone meal pretty easy.
Well, we will need to grow quite a few trees.
Like 4?
Yeah.
I think we can grow. I think we can get bone meal pretty easy.
You mean with the melons?
Yeah.
Should we start the farm? The melon farm?
Maybe. If we're gonna need bone meal.
Mm-hmm. Sounds good. Yeah. You guys also want to watch that? Starting the melon farm?
Oh, yeah. I'm in pre-cam.
I'm inside the melon farm.
So large, can I see you? Okay. Oh, no. Over there. Right. So, oops. Just depower this and it should actually launch. Okay, first one. We have a bit delay in between. Yep. Picking up items.
Yeah.
And the last one.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
Return fine. I'm not sure where the bone meal is going at the moment.
I would think to the dispensers of the farm. Oh, Oh, there's a random basalt laying on the farmland on the other side.
Yeah.
Maybe someone should grab it.
Is it in the way?
Well, it will land inside the dispensers. It's on the side with the mango, quite near the end in the.
Yeah, underneath me. It fell down here.
Yeah.
Will actually not land the dispenser. Will get stuck in the hopper. It feeds the composter, which is also bad.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
But that, when we finish
wait,
this,
was that
in
the
here,
only one?
Yeah, it was the only one.
Yeah.
I only lost one down.
Okay, I got it.
Yeah, nice.
But nice, yeah, then we probably need to, when we finish this, disconnect the hopper system because things will fall into the system.
I've just seen there are a few spots where there's still a melon instead of a seed on the side that's not harvested yet. Mostly on the left side. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5 spots, as far as I can tell.
Okay, the bone meal is kind of getting lost because the water streams are not in yet.
Oh, yeah.
I grabbed the ice and finished it.
Yep. Okay, someone can then, once everyone is ready, just flick the lever. And then everything should hopefully work fine.
Everybody ready?
Yep.
Okay, and let's go. T.
Everything looking good.
TNT is still glitchy client side. Weird. I think it's good.
Well, nothing's exploded, so that's a good
thing. Yeah, that's a good
wow. Oh, and I'm getting a lot of saplings. Perfect.
Nice. So you also don't get any damage, right?
From the TNT?
Mm-hmm.
Everything's
out
fine.
Of the way.
Oh, I moved my mouse.
Okay. I'll try to take a look what happens with the logs if they arrive where they should. Do we already have maybe some in there? Yeah, we got the first logs. Perfect. Oh, didn't you bring some charcoal? We could also fill it in the furnaces a little bit.
Yeah, there's a shulker of it.
Yeah. Let's get that and like spread it over the furnaces. Got everything? Okay. You can then you can flick the switch and then redirect everything to the furnaces.
Should I just do that manually? Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's more important to fill the first hopper, so those here. Yeah, if you just put full stacks in those, the rest will be automatic more or less.
Should I set to charcoal mode?
Yep.
Alright.
Let's see if the logs arrive. Oh yeah, they're already coming. Yep.
So why is the player moving?
Yeah, I'm still moving.
Moving away? Because the first TNT that explodes would damage the player. So as soon as
the peaceful.
True.
Yeah.
Well, we designed this form for general use.
Yeah. So this is for.
Just say that. It's fine.
Yeah.
No one needs to know.
So yeah, this is not just for peaceful. This farm can be used in, you know, regular survival.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Totally forgot about that. Why is nobody brought that up? Yeah. Oh, you got Helga.
Yeah, I hadn't looked at it, so yeah. Just wondering why.
Okay, so our next mega project is also now finished, and I was really happy to see that it worked first try. So now the flying machines got lost for the melon farm, and also the dark oak tree farm didn't blow up. All right, let's explain this a little bit more in detail. So in here we got the tree farm, the dark oak tree farm, and then also supplied with bone meal. Instead of bringing over the bone meal from somewhere else, we decided to build the bone meal farm right next to it and directly hook it up. So here we have a melon farm using the flying machine concept, which really, in my opinion, is really the best melon farm concept because it requires the least amount of effort. Super simple. It supplies us with around 4,800 bone meal per hour. The dark oak tree farm needs about 4,200 bone meal per hour, so we even get a little extra just to be on the safe side. So we can run the tree farm really infinitely. We always have enough bone meal, and also the farm returns enough saplings. So this would work infinitely. What else to say? So yeah, in the end dimension, we also need those jack-o'-lanterns here that are non-movable, so they wouldn't be picked up by the slime blocks in order to supply the melons with enough block light. In the overworld, in most cases, you actually don't need any light sources anymore. I'm not quite sure if this is a bug. I think this actually changed to 1.13 or 1.14. At nighttime, melons would also grow in case you don't have any blocks above, and also other crops. So the older versions at nighttime, nothing would grow unless you would supply block light. But yeah, ever since 1.13, I believe, skylight level 15, even at nighttime, it's good enough to cause the crops to grow. Not sure if this is really intended, but no world you could have built this without the jack-o'-lanterns, in case you don't place any, or not too many blocks above. Right, so that's something I always wanted to do ever since the composter got introduced into the game, build a tree farm that is directly supplied with bone meal. I'm really happy about this. So let's also check out the tree farm real quick. Maybe let's go in free cam for a second so I can show you the composters below. All the hoppers feed into that. And we got another hopper line and the bone mill sent by this water stream and the bubble elevator up to directly to the droppers and dispensers would supply the bone mill to the saplings. Okay. Oh, one more detail, the unloading station here is in the middle. I think this is slightly more efficient than having it at the end. Okay, now let's head over to the tree farm. So we actually changed the design that was released by Fallen Breath about a year ago, made it a bit more efficient. It produces about twice as many logs now. Let's check it out. Also, we had the advantage that honey blocks got introduced ever since we released this video. So here we grow a dark oak tree and then the first TNT is dispensed and shot over on the blast resistant blocks. So here we use ancient debris, so we could easily put the hopper minecarts in there. They would pick up some of the items. Then the TNT blows up most of the logs. So here we use the trick that moving blocks have a lower blast resistance. And then we also dispense former TNT with the dupers here from the top that blow up the rest of the leaves for the saplings and also some of the remaining logs. Timings are really sharp, so sometimes it looks like this is actually happening too early. Somehow I fell in the water. but we did a lot of testing, mostly Panda and Glotz actually did, in order to get the highest possible rates. Okay, how do I get out of there? Still got some enderpearls left. Okay, so items are collected by the water stream here, sent to the hoppers, then into the lower water stream there. We have filters here for the saplings and the dark oak logs. The sticks and apples we get, we don't use for anything. So technically, we could compost the apples to get a little bit more bone meal and use the sticks for the furnaces, but it's not really worth it. We already get enough bone meal and yeah, those copper sticks, they don't help as much. So they just get sent into a cactus. Then, sure, yeah, we also have a little bit of storage down there for dark oak saplings. So one double chest is already filled up. You get more than it's just sent into a fire, blue fire. And yeah, all the logs sent to the storage here, which is already filled up. You got a 250,000 dark oak logs now. The farm reduces, by the way, exactly 21,500 logs per hour, which is, considering that it's so simple, pretty good. Then we also have a switch here. So either send the logs to the charcoal storage, or we redirect the water stream here. You can also send it directly here in the back to the furnace array. But in case the dark oak log storage is filled up, then it's also sent directly to the furnace array. So the furnace array is really as simple as it gets. There's basically just two water streams in the back. So all the logs, it's sent in from the top. And then we use charcoal to fuel those. So at the bottom, the hopper line so sends all the charcoal to a dropper. And we use that charcoal to fuel the same furnaces again. So the charcoal items are sent over a second water stream. Here we just have to do a bit of aligning of the honey blocks and so on. And yeah, resupply that. And in case all the hoppers are filled up, then the rest of the charcoal goes into the storage here on the side. This is also already filled up again. Yep. We got about 100,000 charcoal here already. So yeah, we don't have really a fancy furnace array here with hopper minecart distribution to equally fuel or supply the furnaces. Just because we really kept it simple. This was really meant for using it for a long time. So the disadvantage of just doing it like that is that the first furnace needs to be filled up and the hopper in the back, so the first six stacks go in there, and the second one really takes a while until all the furnaces are turned on, but in the long run, really doesn't matter. Since, well, we can run this without any cost. We get all the bone meal, we get all the saplings, so we can basically run this infinitely. Let's also appreciate the decoration once more. Most of the build effort went into this, and I think it also looks fantastic again. Miles did a really good job on this. And I really like is also here this huge melon farm. This whole building feels like a hangar, and the end dimension even looks a bit more impressive than the overworld. I really like how spacious this is, and it really gives a sense of the scale here. The whole farm is about 160 blocks long. Also a nice little detail here with the mango and the glass blocks. It's really good. Yeah, and here we got the dark oak tree farm. Some solar panels on the side. Also, yeah, try to add little details here on the side. So all the energy from the solar panels hooks up to the main building here. And we got here the huge glass dome for the dark oak tree farm. Okay, yeah, super happy again how this turned out.